Hello there, very good evening to you. We are live tonight from Liverpool. That represents a first for us on Sky Sports, and another important first tonight, the first major world title fight in Britain of the emerging governing body, the World Boxing Union, also known as the WBU. But whatever the initials, the issue always remains the same when it's a title fight. We've got one belt and two men determined to battle it out. Liverpool's Shea Neary, 16 straight wins. He's the home fighter here tonight. All his last 10 wins inside the distance. And against him, it's Tyson. This is the veteran, Darryl Tyson. The usual pre-fight meditation routine from him tonight. He's fought a total of 7 world champions in a long and distinguished career. What can he offer tonight? But this is the belt that they're fighting it out for tonight, the fledgling organization, the WBU, and this is their world light welterweight title belt. But for the fighters in the main event here, truly the most important prize in the world right now. We're at the Everton Park Leisure Centre in the centre of Liverpool, and the main event coming up shortly, Shea Neary against Darryl Tyson. And I'm delighted to welcome back, as usual, Barry McGuigan and Liverpool's new world champion, the WBC World Super Middleweight Champion, Robin Reid. Great to have you with us tonight, Robin. And for Neary, who hopes to follow Reid's footsteps here tonight and become a success story from Liverpool, one or two big names to emulate. Other WBU world champions, including George Foreman, the reigning heavyweights champion. There's also James Toney in the light heavyweights division, Vinny Pazienza, and Kevin Kelly. Now Neary hopes to earn something like similar acclaim.
Whatever anyone says, WBU is going to be, you know, within the next 3 years, going to be the most major title around.
Well, we can understand Neary's wild enthusiasm for this, the biggest occasion in his entire boxing career to date. But Barry, do we really need another boxing organisation?
In my opinion, I don't think we do need another world organisation. However, I will say this is a fabulous fight. I don't think it needs a title. I think this is a fantastic fight. A young up-and-coming guy against the veterans, a fabulous fight. There's no doubt about it. The ingredients are there for what I consider to be a great fight. However, it does provide an opportunity for other fighters. And but I don't like it. I think it devalues the title. The fact that we have another world title dilutes a world championship as far as I'm concerned.
Does it also offer a shot in the arm to the regular bodies? Robin Reid's the WBC world champion at the moment. The whole history of the sport, Barry, has been littered with occasions where people have come along and said the order needs shaking up. We're in that situation now, aren't we?
Well, quite honestly, there are a few positive things about this organisation. It's based in this country. John Robinson's a great guy. Ed Levine's a good guy. I know them. However, it's just the very fact that it's diluting a title and diluting the importance of what this guy's achieved. And I just think that it really, we don't need another title. I like the guys, and I'm sure their ideas are fine, but I just don't like another world body. It dilutes a value of a title.
They're out to prove us wrong here tonight, the WBU, and I must say they've been very welcoming to us. We've had a great welcome all round in your home city here, Robin. There's a bit of a buzz about Liverpool in the boxing game again now?
Yeah, I think it's great for Liverpool. I mean, for Britain and Liverpool, the fact that, you know, you've got young fighters coming through. You know, Liverpool seems to be coming back on the boxing scene. It used to be big years ago. It's coming back on the boxing scene now. You've got Paul Lloyd, who won a Commonwealth title there 2 weeks ago, the week before I won my world title. You've got myself, who's just come back and won a world title.
They tell me that seats for this one were sold out within a day or two of going on sale.
You can always guarantee that you're going to get a good turnout at Liverpool. And, you know, the crowd are great. They always get behind the fighters. And that's great. It's great for boxing.
Good atmosphere in here tonight. Adam Smith on the revival of boxing in this city that's given the world Reid, Hodgkinson and Conte, among many others.
Britain has 5 major boxing centres. London, Sheffield, Manchester, Bristol and Cardiff, but the sleeping giant of Liverpool has woken again and may become the biggest. Liverpool's where I belong, in my Mersey paradise. Andy Holligan kick-started the revival by ripping the British light welterweight title from Paul Ryan, but that was only the beginning.
There's like a few good stables there now. You've got like you've got John Ireland's camp and you've got Stephen Vaughan's camp.
We've rejuvenated the boxing scene on Merseyside. It died a death for the past 5 years, but myself and John Ireland have totally rejuvenated the scene.
Next up, Liverpool won the Commonwealth title courtesy of bantamweight Paul Lloyd, and then Robin Reid brought the WBC super middleweight crown home.
It's all down to shrewd promoting of homegrown talent, proving Liverpool can match anyone in the fight game.
It's always been the London promoters, always getting the exposure, always getting, you know, the publicity. But now it's going to change, unfortunately, and we're happy to say we're going to make a change, you know, Adam, because that's what it is. I mean, we're going to come to the forefront of the promotions because we've got the new crop of lads.
Shea Neary's got his world title chance at home tonight, and hopefully there'll be more to follow.
Liverpool fighters have always been good, but now they're getting an opportunity to, you know, win titles and they're winning them.
John Hyland's other major attraction is heavyweight Magic Matthew Ellis, and he's a manager's dream. He doesn't need promoting.
I'm so fast. I'm the fast heavyweight. Mike Tyson. Let me watch out, because Magic Matthew Ellis is around now.
The phones haven't stopped ringing about this show. Tickets have been like gold dust, only Shea Neary in short of his place tonight, which should be one to remember.
We're going to lift a world title, and we're going to have all the rest of the camp winning, so it's going to be a really great night. And Sky are going to see the best show they've seen for a long time.
Live boxing to come in just a few minutes here from the Everton Park Leisure Centre in Liverpool, and our main event, Shea Neary against Darryl Tyson for the WBU World Light Welterweight crown. Earlier today, Ian Dark took a stroll in the park, Sefton Park to be precise, in the company of Tyson to find out more about this man's very distinguished career.
Dedication means a lot in this boxing game. If he's very fit and dedicated, we will give y'all one hell of a rumble. But, you know, skill-wise, we will see how his skill would look tonight once I begin to fight him or whatever. But you got to have a big heart and dedication and condition goes with this boxing game. I'm not going to the journey stage because once I begin to do that, then you can bet I will retire, and the people that's handling me, as far as my trainer, my management, and the people that are around me that love me, they will put me out of the game instantly. So, no, I won't be a journeyman. I hope they don't think that I am a journeyman at 36 years old. I got a body of a 26-year-old man, and I will prove that tonight.
The ambition and the fire and the desire is still there, is it?
It's never left. It has never left, you know.
People will see your name, Tyson. You're not related, are you?
Well, he's my mother's second cousin. I don't go third and fourth and fifth one. And so no, he's not any kin to me at all.
I'm glad we sorted that out. But in his own right, this man deserves great respect, doesn't he, Barry?
Without a doubt, this is definitely a risk for Shea Neary. This guy has mixed in brilliant company, as Ian talked about earlier. He's already fought world champions. Seven different world champions. He is beginning to, he's on the slippy slope. He still looks very fresh and very sharp, as you can see here. Very lucid, a good talker, and a bright guy. And he is dedicated, you can see that by his condition. But you can't take away the fact that it's his age, you know. And I think Shea Neary will probably be stronger and bigger than him.
Robin, you looking forward to seeing this man tonight?
Yeah, he looks like a good fight. You know, he seems quite confident in the way he spoke. I like that in a fighter, you know, when they don't start saying, I'm going to do him in this round or whatever. But he seems like a confident bloke. Obviously, like Barry said, his age may go against him a bit. But like you say, he reckons he's got the body of a 26-year-old, so we'll have to wait and see.
Well done to Lockett. We'll watch his career progress from here with great interest. Main event coming up shortly here now. It's the fledgling WBU World Light Welterweight title fight, and it's the big chance for Shea Neary, Adam Smith, or what you might consider an old-style fighter.
Shea Neary's story is a throwback to boxing's past, the lonely fighter in a backstreet gym.
I am just a poor boy, though my story is seldom told. I have squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises. All lies and jest, still the man hears what he wants to hear.
His commitment and dedication to training have now put him in contention for a world title.
I'm going to give it 100% on the night, and God willing, I'll do it, you know.
In the clearing stands a boxer and a fighter by his trail, and he carries the reminders of every glove that laid him down or cut him till he cried out in his anger and his shame, I am leaving, I am leaving, but the fighter still remains.
He may be from the old school, but the world title he's fighting for is one of the newest and most controversial.
I don't care what it is in the world title I fight for. Couldn't care about, you know, fought for a Mickey Mouse title or whatever. The person I'm fighting, the world-class opponent, whatever anyone says, WBU is going to be, you know, within the next 3 years, going to be the most major title around.
we think it's great, you know, the WBU. I believe it, you know, it's got George Foreman, James Toney, Kevin Kelly, incredible world titles, and we believe it's going to be like, I would say when the media started, when Sky first come in, competing with ITV and BBC, obviously, you know, everyone went, well, what's Sky going to do? But Sky obviously took over, and Sky has been a breath of fresh air, and he vitalised boxing. And I believe the WBU is going to do the same.
If I win this title, I'm a world champion. You've seen the belt is gorgeous, you know, and I'll be proud to wear that belt.
Shea Neary's boxing world is straight out of the 40s and 50s. That's when fighters were fighters. That's when being champion of the world meant just that. Today might be different, but winning the WBU version will give Shea Neary his own special place in the sport.
Live in his dressing room, this is the man they call the Shamrock Express. Now, mainly because of his tremendous knockout rate and his record of 14 knockouts in 16 starts certainly suggests a big puncher. Is this your impression too, Barry?
Yeah, he's a bigger and physically stronger guy than Tyson, but he's up against a very experienced, very knowledgeable, good chin. The only defeat that he's had inside the distance, well, the only sort of shocking defeat was against De La Hoya. So we know he's tried and tested, he's got a good chin, he's still got plenty of ability left. And he can really fight, and he's bringing to the ring with him a load of knowledge.
This is a sort of a romantic story for Neary, though, Robin, isn't it? Because, you know, there are hundreds of fighters around the country who are working hard day in, day out, year in, year out, and not getting a chance. This man's been given the chance on home territory tonight.
Yeah, that's what I mean. That's what the positive points about this WBO title now is, that you can have fighters like Neary coming through and winning a title and making a bit of an impact on the world scene. I mean, if he doesn't go on to do anything else, you know, I mean, I hope the lad all the best and I hope he wins it. If he doesn't do anything else, you know what I mean, he could say he was WBU world champion.
Doesn't look like being easy tonight, though, Barry, against Tyson, does it?
It certainly isn't. It reminds me, in a way, of my fight against Juan Laporte many years ago. It's you're stepping up there into unknown territory. This guy is better than every one of his previous opponents put together. However, he is 36 years old. Neary's no spring chicken at 28, but he's a bigger, stronger guy, hungrier, and he's got his home crowd with him, and he really wants to win.
Right, very exciting prospect. It's coming after this short break. We'll see you again in just a moment or two. The judgment night, November the 9th, Mike Tyson against Evander Holyfield is one of three world heavyweight title fights live on Sky Box Office. For more information on this special pay-per-view event, please call us 0990 800 888. But the main event now is Shea Neary against Darryl Tyson. We're at the Everton Park Leisure Centre, midway between the homes of Liverpool FC and Everton FC. Honours even here. Kieran Dolman, the young man carrying the Union Jack, is in the Everton blue, and the young man in the red of Liverpool is Joseph Stockton.
Our world wasn't able to see.
And the music is supplied by Simply Red, and the thought occurs that it's red for Mick Hucknall, but it's not Liverpool red. Anyway, great atmosphere. Every seat for this sold within a few hours of going on sale. The public in Liverpool have really warmed to having such an occasion on their doorstep here tonight. And we are ready to go. Our Sky Sports commentary team tonight, Glenn McCrory and Ian Dark, and our Master of Ceremonies, John McDonald.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's fight of the night time. And making his way to the ringside now, would you please welcome, from the United States of America, Darryl Terrible T. Tyson!
Well, what a contrast. 8 months ago, Darryl Tyson was fighting at Caesars Palace, Las Vegas, against the brilliant young Oscar De La Hoya. It's a long way from all that glamour and glitz to the Everton Park Sports Centre in the back streets of Liverpool. But Tyson is a fighter with a mortgage to pay, and he has a world-class pedigree too. Two tilts at the World Lightweight Crown, and among his victims in a decade at the top, world champions Jimmy Paul and big-hitting Roger Mayweather. The question is, does he still have the desire and ambition to match strides and punches with a fired-up newcomer an up-and-coming prospect like Shea Neary. Fighting a long way from home. But he's fit and he's ready. He's been here a week. He's over the jet lag. And he says, who's Shea Neary? I've never heard of him before. I've been mixing with the top men. I'm not going to be worried about an assignment like this. We'll see.
And ladies and gentlemen, stand by. The Shamrock Express. Shea Neary.
Well, it's a Nigel Benn-style entrance for a Liverpool fighter with a Nigel Benn kind of style. Fiery, aggressive, big puncher. 16 straight wins, 14 inside schedule, and 11 of them inside three rounds. He calls himself the Shamrock Express. Very fit, very dedicated, and tonight, the acid test. Is he good enough to move into world class? Absolutely sensational atmosphere here. 1,200 people packed to the rafters. At ringside, they paid £60 to see this. The rest of them, £25. Intimate arena. And Shea Neary is their hero. Tale of the tape. Neary's 28. They've got to get a move on with him. But Tyson at the veteran stage now, just turned 36. About the same height. Neary right on the light welterweight limit. Tyson just inside. Reach, not much in it. Tyson, look at the rounds. He's fought nearly nine times as many rounds as Shea Neary. Vastly experienced. Big, big gap. Will that be a factor here? Neary, though, with a great knockout percentage of 87 so far. These are the rules of the fledgling World Boxing Union. No three knockdown rule for this particular world governing body. The bell can save a fighter only in the last round of the contest. And now the national anthem's coming up.
Ladies and gentlemen, sports fans, would you please be upstanding for the national anthems, which will be sung by your very own Mike Morrissey.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes, bright stars through the perilous fight, all the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the red rocket's glare from the bursting in air gave proof to the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave. God save our gracious Queen, long live our
Tremendous buzz around the place as we await the introductions from MC John McDonald here.
Ladies and gentlemen, sports fans, Monroe and Ireland Brothers, in association with Frank Maloney and Parrots Promotions, proudly present 12 3-minute rounds of boxing for the vacant World Boxing Union's Light Welterweight Championship of the World. Sponsored by Sunny Premium Indian Lager, the undisputed, undefeated king of beers. And we welcome our Sky viewers joining us live and exclusive here on Ringside. You've joined us for the best ringside seat in the business. All the officials have been appointed by the World Boxing Union in association with the British Boxing Board of Control. Here present at ringside, President John Robinson from Norfolk in England, Supervisor Ed Levine from Florida, USA, and the judges here present at ringside, Judge Dave Paris from London, Judge Don O'Neill from Boston, USA, and Judge Torben Hansen from Denmark. Timekeeper Colin Roberts, and when the action begins, the referee in charge of his 61st World Title Championship is Steve Smoger from Atlantic City. Well, there the officials are. Here are the contestants. Firstly, and introducing to you, fighting out of the blue corner, he's wearing the white trunks trimmed with blue. He weighed 9 stone, 13.5 pounds, and brings a staggering 57 fight record, 47 wins and only 9 defeats and 1 draw, 24 of them wins coming by the way of that big KO. He's the former NABF and USBA lightweight champion from Washington, D.C., the United States of America, Terrible T, Darryl Tyson. And ladies and gentlemen, sports fans, fighting out of the red corner, he's wearing the solid black trunks, weighted at 10 stone, and brings an undefeated record of 16 contests, 16 wins, 14 coming by the way of that big KO. He's from Liverpool, by way of Dublin, is the Shamrock Express, Shea Neary. So, sports fans, here we go. We're going to raise some hell at the sound of the bell with 12 3-minute rounds of boxing for the vacant World Boxing Union's Light Welterweight Championship of the World.
Well, a sort of Anfield or Goodison style fanaticism behind Shea Neary here.
Obey my commands at all times. Respect the bell at all times. Fellas, and above all, protect yourself at all times. Touch him up. Touch him up. Please. Thank you. Let's go.
Referee Steve Smoger from Atlantic City. He's a judge who incidentally has sent 30 men to death row. Tough guy. He's in charge, all right. Shea Neary, can he follow in the famous Liverpool boxing bootprints of the likes of Alan Rudkin, John Conte, Paul Hodkinson, fighting here for the vacant WBU version of the light welterweight title. Neary in the black trunks, throwback kind of fighter, but this a massive, massive step up in class against Darryl Tyson. But Tyson, in his last fight, was beaten in 2 rounds by the brilliant Oscar De La Hoya. How much did that take away from him?
And Neary certainly got a wonderful following to really gee him up and bring the very best out of him.
We'll be watching to see how much appetite and ambition Tyson has for the job. Around here, they say anybody that Neary hits stays down. Will that work now that he's moved up into world class? Very, very durable, this man. Normally, Tyson stopped only twice in 57 fights over 14 years. And he really has mixed with all the best lightweights and light welterweights around, with the exception of Julio Cesar Chavez.
But Neary really just knows one way to fight. He likes to go forward. He's an action-packed fighter. He really tries to rumble all over his opponent. I'm sure that's what he'll want to do with Tyson. But Tyson, very, very experienced.
Big, big night. Maybe a defining night in the career, this, of Shea Neary. He's one of a number of very good talents we have in this division at the moment. And another one is right here in Liverpool, the British and Commonwealth champion, Andy Holligan. And if Neary should win this, there'd be a lot of drum beating for a fight between those two, though they are in rival camps. But first, he's got to get Tyson out of the way. Missed with those three, and that one as well, did Neary. Despite the roar of the crowd.
Yes, Tyson just shown a little bit of experience there, just rolling with them punches. He's been around, he's been with some very, very good fighters, and bags of experience.
Good body shot from Neary, who's certainly the one taking the fight to Tyson in this opening round.
This is a very big night for Neary, and really it's how much nerves will play a part for him. Tyson has been there many times before. He knows the big occasion.
Good looking left hook from Neary. That just sent Tyson reeling backwards momentarily. Got him with some good body punches. Neary was doing the best work, certainly, in this opening round. Good jab and looking for the uppercut, but that one didn't land. And a good stiff jab again. Neary's opening round all right. Welcome back to the Everton Park Sports Centre. We're live tonight. The vacant WBU light welterweight title on the line, and Shea Neary, the man going for it. Didn't he start well, Glenn McCrory?
He started very well. That was a good, strong start for Neary. He needed to do that. He needed to land some good punches on Tyson in the opening round. We see the statistics there, 48 thrown, 70 landed, and certainly Neary the better of it in that round.
Certainly no sign of nerves from Neary, who's been inactive for the past 9 months since his win over Terry Sutherland. Brilliant knockout win that, when he'd been cut as well and looked in trouble. Now, what has Tyson got to offer us? Maybe he was just taking a look at Neary in that opening round. Let's see. A little short left hook from him. Will the American try to assert himself a wee bit more? Certainly come out looking as if he wants to mix it, doesn't he, now?
Yes, I think the corner's had a word with Tyson. They're sure to just try and take over now.
Good left uppercut inside from Neary. He's being asked questions now by this world-class American from Washington, D.C. A man who grew up on the tough streets of the ghettos in that city, alongside Keith Holmes, who beat Richie Woodall in a world middleweight title fight last week. Good hand speed from Tyson on the inside there.
Tyson's starting to pick some good punches up the middle, and the right hand over the top.
And another one, and then a right through the middle. Danger moments for Neary. Important for him to get through this little patch. Suddenly, Tyson has slipped into gear in this second round. Neary must have known it wasn't going to be as easy for him as it was in the first. Maybe 36, Darryl Tyson now, but bags of fighting pride, and he's come back in his career before when he seemed to be just slipping a bit too.
Neary just throwing punches there, just a little too wild. He's a little keyed up here, and he's missing quite a bit against Tyson. Tyson looks a lot more confident than that.
Second round, just as Neary was under pressure, quickly up, mandatory eight count. It was a left hand that did it by Neary. He does have some power, this man from Liverpool. The crowd here are going absolutely potty.
That's exactly what he needed, just as Tyson was trying to put the pressure on. He had to come back, and he found the answers, Neary.
Terrific punch from him, and he's turned this thing around now in the second round. Tyson had started pretty well, good left jab from him, but Tyson has now felt Neary's power like a few before him. That was a great round. Well, that would have been a 10-8 round, I think, for Shea Neary with the knockdown. Well, what an answer, just as Tyson was really beginning to unleash himself.
He really needed it at that point. It was a different Tyson. You could see he was a lot stronger. He was coming forward. Look, good punches from Tyson then. And then Neary came back, them two little short punches to put Tyson over. But he just answered the questions right at the right time, just when Tyson was on the verge of getting on top.
Right hand and then a left hook, dumping Darryl Tyson down in round two. That's a big breakthrough.
Two little short punches from Neary. Shows what sort of power he has.
And he's had 14 of those 16 wins inside schedule in only 4 years as a professional. And he does bang very hard indeed. Neary, the home city fighter here in the black trunks. Is he going to make it a glory night for Liverpool? But we saw signs in that last round of Tyson's quality, didn't we? Oh, a great right uppercut as well from Neary. Then a right to the body as well, and a left uppercut inside. This is impressive boxing.
Tyson again trying to move forward, put a bit of pressure, close the distance down and get close to Neary.
Good little right over the top there from Tyson. Worth reminding ourselves how often he's been in there at world class before. And not only lasted the distance with the top men, but beaten quite a few of them as well. People like Jimmy Paul, Jaime Balboa, Lupe Suarez, Roger Mayweather, Reggie Green.
Good work from Neary using the jab. He's just keeping Tyson off balance.
That fascinating equation here of the up-and-comer with big ambitions against the old soldier who's been to the top. Does he have the desire to stay around there?
Well, on paper, this certainly had the makings of a very good fight and is living up to be that.
The right seemed to catch the gloves of Tyson. And that hit the arms, despite the roar of the crowd. And of course, that does sometimes influence the judges as well. But you get the impression here that Neary's punch power could be a big factor in this.
Yes, and he's keeping nice and aggressive, Neary. He's not allowing Tyson to get back in the fight. Tyson very experienced. He knows when to switch up in gears.
Doubling up on the jab, Darryl Tyson. Neary coming back with exactly the same. And repeating it as well. Every time Tyson has started to posed questions, Neary's had an answer so far. Can he keep this up at this far more dizzy level for him?
Good to see Neary using the boxing green and turning his head over the corner there.
Another good round that for Neary. Well, three rounds gone, and it's going very well for Shea Neary so far. He's had Tyson on the floor. This is action from round three.
Yes, and he just got the best of it there with that good right uppercut from Neary. Good aggressive work, but I'm pleased to see him using the jab, and he's just keeping Tyson off balance with that. That's something new, showing the boxing brain, Neary. All good work, and finishing with a nice flurry on the ropes.
And then scorecard with Neary in a handy lead. 10-8 round for him in round two. This may be a very early stage in the story. We'll see. The fourth, and of course it's due to go 12. Neary covering up well. There's a hitting the gloves, those shots. And I think Neary's punches were as well. People on their feet all around the arena.
But Tyson's showing his character here. He hasn't just come over here to make the numbers. He's prepared well. He's in good shape and he's really trying to take the fight to Neary. And he's gonna answer questions of Neary's character.
Whipping little right cross from Neary, looks impressive. Again, he's looking for that sliding right uppercut. That whistled past the end of the balls. Another good right hand. It just seemed to hurt Tyson momentarily. Just staggered into Neary when that one landed.
Neary getting the best of it inside. These are the more hurtful punches, and I think he's pulling in Neary's hand a little bit here, Tyson.
Huge deafening shot now of Neary all around this arena. The Liverpool crowd trying to roar on the man they call the Shamrock Express. Tyson looking quality in little cameo moments in the fight, but Neary with that extra dig, you feel, is the one who's bossing it at the moment.
But Tyson's trying to get his jab working here, but he's just falling short. Neary just managing to pick the punches off.
Oh, was a terrific left uppercut inside there from Tyson. Real class shot that was, wasn't it?
Yes, he shows his quality. Nice loose style, brings punches from all sorts of angles, Tyson. Two good little punches there, the left and the right over the top.
Another one, and Neary might be in a bit of trouble there. Left uppercut as well. Four or five head punches started in, and Neary intend to hold on.
The legs of Neary just look to skip a little bit there.
Looking for the countering right hand. I think he only just lost balance. Nothing more there, Tyson. Very, very good performance so far from Neary, but still a long way to go. And Tyson, in this round, has showed that he might still be very dangerous in this contest.
Judgment night, November the 9th, Britain's Henry Akinwande defending against Alexander Zolkin, one of three world heavyweight title fights live on Sky Box Office. Special pay-per-view event, call 0990-800-888 for information. Neary against Tyson here now. Here's the fifth.
Really exciting fight so far. Neary sent out by his corner men, Georgie Schofield, Kenny Willis, Mike Atkinson and Judas Clotty for round five. And they must be proud of the effort he's put up so far. But he's still a long, long way from winning this very, very big fight for him against the former world title contender at lightweight, one weight down from this, Darryl Tyson. And he did, of course, fight De La Hoya as well at light welter.
Well, Tyson may be 36, but he's still showing his, he's still got plenty left.
Any thought at all that Tyson had come over here just for a payday and to look for the canvas, those thoughts have been dispelled. He's getting in with some good shots, but Neary again answers him. There's a real trade-off between them. And it may well be that Neary is the one with the extra punch power if it's going to be that kind of battle.
Yes, with the punch power he possesses, Neary's always got a chance in close like that.
Great left hook from Neary. Very good hand speed from him round the side. But Tyson has that loose, classy way about him that the top American fighters have, hasn't he?
That's right, and there's only the very, very top fighters have ever stopped Tyson. He knows how just to sway out of the way, just to take the power off the punches a little bit. He's also went into the late stages in the fight many times, of which Neary hasn't. So there could be question marks against Neary in the later stages.
Neary's never been beyond six rounds before. Worth remembering that. And Tyson has fought in six tough 12-rounders. Might experience come into play. Fascinating one. Action just slowing slightly in the fifth. Probably the quietest round so far.
Yes, for the first time, fourth fighter's just prepared to stand off a little bit, look for jabs, just try and find a way through the defences.
Tyson coming back with his own damaging looking left.
Some good little counter punching inside there from Tyson.
Really cagey, skillful operator, Darryl Tyson. And this argument isn't over yet. Welcome back to the Everton Park Sports Centre. A terrific contest going on here for the vacant WBU version of the light welterweight title.
Yes, and a very close round there. You see this good left hook. That was a real solid one, but Tyson, for his credit, he took it very well and came back.
99 landed in the contest from Neary, 79 from Tyson so far, according to the computer. Just a rough guide for you. Clem and I have Neary in a decent lead at this point. I've got him 3 points ahead. What about you, Glenn?
I've got him three, but I had Tyson just doing good work in the last round. Some nice little counters. But Neary still, he's gritty and determined, and every time Tyson comes to him, he's coming back well.
Tyson, who's been quietly preparing this week in the Sefton area of Liverpool, got himself lost running in Sefton Park one morning, but enjoying his stay. Will he still be enjoying it at the end of this one? He's making it a really good test for Neary, isn't he?
Yes, it was always the thought that he would. That he would always be there, very experienced, very good fighter. I think a lot of question marks for how much the Oscar De La Hoya defeat took out of Tyson. That was a shattering defeat for him.
But he's had a good long gap since then, hasn't he?
He's had a long rest and there's still plenty left.
Out of range with the jab. Not that time though, Neary. Stiff jab from Neary. Frank just starting to get a wee bit more technical as it goes on.
Neary had to take a good right hand then left hook, but he's just a busy with the jab in this round.
Just an extra work rate from Shea Neary. Not a lot in it. The last two or three rounds have got closer. Now there's a cut underneath the right eye of Darryl Tyson. Won't be a real problem for him. Blood's not running into the eye. Good left uppercut from Tyson. And now left hook. Neary found an answer.
But you see the class from Tyson in that little exchange. But the character from Neary, he comes storming back just to take the judge's eye there.
The will to win and intensity of Neary are plain to see here. Ooh, a caught by a fast countering right hand.
He's never ever been in with anybody like this before, not remotely this good, with due respect to the people he's beaten before.
Neary will have to be in really good shape for this fight because he's been made to wait, to work so very, very hard.
Close round. Welcome back. There is the face of Darryl Tyson from Washington, D.C. A man who was inspired to box by the Thriller in Manila way back in the 70s.
Neary really using his head. He's changing his tactics very much, using the head, going the body. But I think I'm very pleased the way he's using that jab just to keep Tyson off balance.
Well, Neary's never been this far before. Seventh round. And this is 17th pro contest. Neary in the black shorts, the home city fighter here from Liverpool. Neary's had to rely more on his boxing in the last couple of rounds or so. Oh, it's a terrific left hook. It really was a great shot, that by Neary. Then a left uppercut as well. And I think Tyson is in the spot of bother from all of that. The left hook, he really had to bite and dig deep there, Tyson. He was really kind of trying to hold back the pain almost from it.
Yes, that was a very solid punch, good left hook. But again, Tyson's took it well.
And that just shows how durable this American is. Neary's a big puncher, and he produced an absolute humdinger there. Tyson took it. And his head seems to have cleared. Tyson, of course, has shown his resilience before. Neary mustn't become discouraged by that, the fact that Tyson's still there in front of him.
Yeah, I think a lot of question marks are going to be how Neary handles this mentally as he goes in the later stages. He's never been in the late stages in a fight, never been past six before, and that could start worrying him a little bit. He can't have any doubts about his fitness in a fight like this.
Looks like Tyson is now cut above the right eye and below it. Bit of blood around, and he's breathing a little more heavily now. Is this heavier punching of Neary just beginning to get to him here? I think that left hook really shook him up.
Again, just reverting back to the jab, Neary, and that's a good plan in this fight. Never do the same thing too often, keep changing it around.
That looks worse underneath that right eye of Darryl Tyson. And Neary showing here that he's not only a puncher, he can box a bit as well. He's showing that he's got a bit of a repertoire about him. Left, lucky for him it didn't land flush, that Neary, because he was right out of position for a moment. Oh, good right uppercut too from Neary. He's having an excellent round here, and another left uppercut on the inside as well.
Yes, you can sense he's just starting to hurt Tyson with some of these punches. Tyson just hasn't got the zip he had in the early rounds.
The big question mark now has to be whether Neary has the stamina to see the job through. He's never been into this territory before. Hardly a spare seat. I don't think there are any. In fact, it only holds 1,200. They wanted a bigger arena for this. In fact, they wanted to stage it in an open-air kind of venue, in a marquee on the Albert Dock. But that idea fell through. But Liverpool hoping for a bigger arena to put on these fighters. That was the left hook, Glenn.
That was the good punch of the round. I think that really took a lot of spark out of Tyson. He really got that one flush on the face, and it was a very heavy punch. And there wasn't a lot of comeback from Tyson for the rest of the round.
Watching it ringside, well, hardly able to watch in absolute pain. Karen, Shea Neary's wife, they've got three children as well. Shea's been boxing since he was 15. He did spend 4 years in the King's Regiment along the way. Eighth round here. Neary in the black trunks in front at the moment. We think He's had Tyson on the floor, and at the moment he's passing the test. And it has to be said, tonight Neary has looked like a world-class light welterweight. You've got him five ahead.
Yes, I've got him in a good lead, Neary. He's doing everything right, showing a good boxing grin, good work with the jab, and he's mixing it up, and he's still landing his heavy punches. And I think he's bound to be frustrating Tyson. Tyson won't show it. He's very experienced, but this will be getting to Tyson a little.
But are there any more shocks in store along the way here? My view is that Liverpool should have produced a lot more top-class fighters than it has, but maybe this man can lead the way of a boxing revival. Big right to the body there. Seemed to just stagger Tyson. Maybe he was more off balance than anything, but it was a good shot. Ever since that left hook, Tyson has looked pretty tentative, hasn't he?
He has, but I think it's good to see Neary switching things around a bit, just going on a bit of a move around and then coming forward and using the jab. He's shown a lot more than he has in several of his fights before, Neary.
Dabbing away at the cut as well, Tyson now. This is a man who's been the distance with the likes of Miguel Angel Gonzalez, an excellent Mexican fighter in the WBC lightweight title fight with Rafael Ruelas as well. Never underestimate fighters of this kind of quality. He just could still have something in the locker for Neary.
Proud fighter, he'll want to give it his all, and he's going to try and ask questions of Neary, but it's good work from Neary with a jab.
Uppercut inside, then another left with the gum shield come out of Tyson there. Something went flying. I think it might have just been the sweat, actually. Optical illusion, no stoppage to put the gum shield back in. Neary just beginning to tee off a little. Oh, another big uppercut, staggered Tyson, in trouble. Didn't he take that well? His legs buckled for a moment, but he was back and working within a split second. What a resilient fighter.
Well, I think a lot of fighters would have went down from punches like that, but Tyson still there, still trying to fight back. He's a real tough old pro, this Darryl Tyson.
Isn't he? Isn't he just? But a great round for Neary, who's a long way in front now. ...14 stoppage wins in 16 so far. Can he become only the third man in 58 fights to stop Darryl Tyson?
Well, these were the punches that almost did it. He got all his leverage into that left hook, and look at the legs of Tyson there. It was remarkable of him to stand up to that punch, but he came back. He's a real tough, rugged professional. There we see it again. Look at the legs. Beautiful, all his leverage into that punch, Neary.
It's a very shrewd piece of matchmaking this tonight, I think, too, by the Liverpool promoters getting this fight with Tyson, because doing it, Neary also bypasses the likes of Andy Holligan, the British and Commonwealth champion, Peter Richardson, Paul Ryan, Paul Byrne, John Thaxton. Good light welterweights around in Britain, but Neary trying to get at least a version, it has to be said, a very lightly regarded version of a world title, the WBU.
But I think it's the fight that's important. I think for his confidence to win against a fighter like Darryl Tyson will just give him unbelievable amount of confidence.
Oh, it'd be his passport to the big time, no doubt about that. Massive occasion for him.
If he could stop Darryl Tyson, that really puts him in the big time. There'll be some very good matches out for him if he can do that.
Chopping left from Tyson. But he's looking tired now, the American, and he's just beginning to look as if he's treading treacle a little. Has Neary broken his resistance, or is he close to doing it? I think if he could find another one of those huge left hooks, that just might signal a stoppage. There's a timeout here, Steve Smoger, the referee.
Neary being taken back to his corner. They, I think, want something wiped away, or is the... Now, the gloves come loose. Gloves come loose.
There's just a little bit of tape hanging loose from the thing. They just want that cut off the end, so that's nice and clean at the glove.
Yeah, don't want that flicking into the other fellow's eye. Hazardous enough business without that. Action continues in this ninth round. At this stage of the contest, you feel Tyson is just digging deep and hanging in there, not much more.
Because he's just trying to keep up with the pace of Neary with good uppercuts inside and then switching it to the body.
It's not just been a big hitting performance this from Neary, it's been a very skillful one as well.
Stick it out, Jimmy.
He showed himself to be a thinking fighter. Those people, and there are a few who think the British boxing scene is dead, want to take a look at people like Neary. We've got a few of them around coming through at the moment.
Tyson trying to get his jab going, but Neary just his higher work there, just keeping Tyson busy. A little bit of damage around Neary's nose now from a good solid jab from Tyson.
Dig in, Jimmy, dig in. Dig in, Jimmy.
Well, caught by a countering left on the way through there. Is Neary. He has to be careful about those. He's put in a terrific effort. We trust, from a British point of view, that he isn't going to tie up in the finishing straight.
But this is the stage in the fight when it's going to start getting hard for Neary. He's never been here before. It's a tough fight. He's worked very hard, and he's going to start feeling the pace, waiting for a second wind about this time now.
The cut is worse underneath that right eye of Tyson. They're not going to stop it for that, though. Don't you worry about that. But it's getting harder for Neary.
On Judgment Night, November the 9th, Michael Moore defends against Francois Botha, one of three world heavyweight title fights, live on Sky Box Office. Special pay-per-view event. For more details, call us 0990 800 888. We're going into the 10th round here at the Everton Park Leisure Centre. Shea Neary against Darryl Tyson, and it is a thriller.
10th round, Shea Neary looking to join the likes of George Foreman, James Toney and Vinny Pazienza, who are WBU champions. Now there's a problem in the corner of Darryl Tyson at the moment. I think the bandaging around the glove is loose. It's no problem, there's not going to be a stoppage or anything like that. And he gets a bit more time here. Well, this is handy for Tyson, isn't it, at this stage?
Yes, but the referee just pulled the tape off now. He wanted the scissors and the corner was slow to give them, so he just pulled the tape off.
Mind you, it was handy for Neary as well. He got the extra break, of course. 10th round. Can Neary keep up this terrific effort? Setting up Tyson with the jab, then the left hook. Well, hasn't been much from the American, has there, Glenn, in recent rounds?
He's just, the fight has been took out of the American. He's just using the jab so well, keeping the pressure on him, and this is a real confident display from Shea Neary.
Superb ramrod left jab from him. Just content to work behind that at the moment, Neary. And maybe feeling now he might be able to freewheel home. But will he? Gum shields come out of one of the fighters.
Yes, that's Neary, just lost the gum shield there.
When there's a lull, the referee will stop it to allow that to go back in. There's no lull at the moment, and it's Neary doing the best of the work. Tyson's face beginning to look a bit of a mess. The blood now is starting to just blur his vision a little bit there. He looks a bit swollen under that right eye as well. Now the gum shield will go back in. The action becoming a little fractured in the closing stage. There was such a pace about it, it had to slow up. But at the moment, Neary is in a big, big lead. And it's a question, really, of whether he can hold on, whether Tyson gets a second win somehow.
That's right, he's really put a lot of pressure on Tyson. And Tyson really badly cut and badly bruised. And Neary really just got to keep this pressure on, keep using the jab. Tyson, very experienced, still trying to look, throw a flurry of punches in the late stages.
Neary is on top at the moment. And the points lead he has is opening up all the time. Steve Smoger just taking a slightly closer look at that damage by the left eye of Darryl Tyson. It's been worsening. Heads coming dangerously close together in that exchange. Right uppercut was a good shot too from Neary. Heroic effort this from him. A night that he is never ever going to forget. Again, good looking shots from Tyson, but he doesn't seem to have the power to trouble.
He hadn't got the snap that he had in the early rounds. Obviously this work rate from Neary took a lot out of Tyson. Tyson's still trying to work with that left hook inside, just trying to get some power in close.
The first world title fight of any kind in this city since John Conte against Len Hutchings back in 1976. 20 years ago, is Neary going to make it one of the great sporting nights for Liverpool here? At the moment, the answer to that is yes, but there are still 6 minutes remaining. There's the computer printout, Glenn. It looked, that tells the story in a way.
That really does. He's throwing a lot more punches, landing a lot more. It's good success rate. And I'm just glad to see him using that jab, just keeping Tyson off balance. It's a real thoughtful boxing approach from Neary. He showed us in all the build-up how he can punch, and now he's shown that he can box and use his head and keep changing things around. He's done it so well.
Looking tired, Darryl Tyson. It's his 58th fight tonight, 47 victories, 9 defeats, and nearly all of those have been against world-class operators. Only Freddie Pendleton and Oscar De La Hoya have stopped him before this, and that is why Neary, for all the excellent punches he's thrown, just can't finish this man off. Now Tyson, now I wondered if we might see something like this from him. Does he sense that Neary's failing? Neary with a great right hand. That was the answer from Shea Neary. Tyson came out really upping the tempo, looking to test Neary again, and a thunderous right hand was Shea Neary's answer.
But look at this from Tyson in this late stages. He's took a lot of punches and he's still trying to make a big fight of it. Flurries of punches coming from Tyson, but Neary again found the answer.
And he's done that every time in the contest. I can tell you that nobody in this arena, hardly, except the people immediately at ringside, are sitting down on their seats. They're all standing up. 1,200 of them crammed into this Everton Park Sports Centre on a thunderous night of action. What a fighter this Darryl Tyson is as well. Shea Neary has put in a superb performance, but he still can't quite put out the fire of this excellent veteran.
There's a lot of credit's got to go out to Tyson, really making a fight of it. He's come here to win this title. He's worked so hard, and I think it's brought the very best out of Shea Neary.
Neary buying a bit of time, happy to hold on himself maybe now. Is he beginning to feel the pace of this? Caught with a right hand, then a left hook. Danger moments for Neary, leaving himself open. Two left hooks, another right hand, but the punches bounce off him. Tyson just doesn't quite have that extra punch power. Only about half his wins have come inside schedule.
But it's amazing how Tyson, in a hectic 11th round, can try and throw flurries like he has. But credit to Neary, he's so strong, he's took them punches and come firing back.
That is a deep gash now underneath that right eye of Tyson. His face is a mess. But he still believes he can pull this one out of the fire. Clearly. Never let anybody say that Shea Neary was fighting a old fighter who didn't have anything left, because Tyson has offered plenty here, and Neary has been asked a lot, and he's answered it all in the affirmative so far.
Again, using his head, Neary just trying to get back behind the jab, just settle down a little bit.
What a wonderful round. That's magnificent stuff. That 11th round, Tyson came out so fast. Second win for him, and then Neary with a great right hand to put a finish to that rally. Shea Neary, whose real name is Jimmy Neary, but he calls himself Shea for boxing purposes, as a mark of respect to his dad's memory. His dad was called Shea. There's Karen Neary. Well, not much more of it to endure. And Darryl Tyson has his support here as well.
But he's lasted the course so well, Shea Neary. He's worked for this fight so very well and finds himself in the last round. What a terrific fight it's been.
Last round, 3 minutes to go. And Darryl Tyson will need a knockout here. I'm absolutely positive of that, to rescue this. And he's looking for it with that right hand, wasn't he, too?
He really was. He knows, he will know. He's experienced enough to know that he's behind now, and he knows he has to find the big punch. So I think we've got to be looking for that from Tyson. But remember, Neary has such a wonderful punch himself, and he's the one that's landed the bigger punches throughout this fight.
He's a long way ahead on points. I've got him 7 points ahead going into the last round, Neary. Just remember, for the WBU's version of the light welterweight title, then same margin, 7 points for Neary. He just has to get through these 3 minutes, not do anything silly, and he's really graduated to world class.
But the crowd are going to cheer him through these final couple of minutes. They're behind him, man, all the way.
A minute and 50 seconds to go. Keep your eye on the clock. That's important now. Again, dabbing away at the cut by the right eye. Darryl Tyson, has he got one last rally left in him? It would be absolute agony for Shea Neary after all this if somehow Tyson did find the punches to stop him. Touch wood for Neary. There's no sign of it at the moment. It's been a quiet last round, and that suits him. There are 2 seconds left and counting.
Yes, again, showing good experience so late in a fight, Neary. Just trying to box, just get behind the jab, take no chances, don't get caught with anything silly. He's really come of age in the boxing world tonight, Shea Neary.
Hasn't he just? It's been a magnificent performance, this, by Neary. He must know his way ahead. Tyson is breathing hard. We are 40 seconds away now from the final bell. He's caught by a left hand there, Neary, and one or two hearts go into mouths among his fans, and you can almost feel the tension among the Liverpool crowd, just willing Neary to get through it. Come on, don't do anything daft, they're saying to him. Don't leave any room where you could get counterpunched. But it does look now as if this is going to be a real Merseyside glory night for Shea Neary. When that final bell goes, there will be the most deafening noise around here. I'm absolutely positive of that. They think he's got it. We're pretty sure he's got it.
And
there goes the bell to end it. And Shea Neary has surely lifted the belt, the WBU belt. But we await the scorecards. There's wife Karen, just happy to see her man getting through the experience unscathed. But what a great performance that was by Shea Neary.
It really was. No heroics from Neary in the last round. He knew he was a big, big winner. He thinks he's a big, big winner. And he just wanted to keep out of trouble. Don't be silly. Don't let Tyson have a free shot. And he did that so well. And It's a big, big night for Liverpool and a big night for Neary.
That is Glenn McCrory's scorecard. You've got it. What is that? By, ooh, seven points. Last round even, yeah, I thought so. Nothing happened much, did it?
Not really. He just took a backward step, had a long look. He knows he's, I'm sure he knows he's a big winner here.
I've got a seven-point win for Neary as well. John Hyland is there. It's a terrific night, you know, too, for the Liverpool promoters. John and Stephen Hyland and Neil Munro, the man about town, who seems to know everybody on Merseyside. They're trying to lead this boxing revival here. Frank Maloney's working with them as well tonight, Lennox Lewis's promoter. And if Neary has won this, and we think he surely has, and I think Tyson thinks Neary's won as well. I mean,
yes,
he didn't have that race.
Sure. He's so experienced. He'll know he hasn't done enough. A good performance from Neary. He's really come of age. And I think great to see such an enthusiasm from the crowd in this area, who's, you know, been starved of top quality boxing for so long. And it's back, and it's back with Shea Neary.
Throwback kind of fighter. No frills about him. Big punch, works hard, and all that road running around Liverpool, all that work at the Kirby Sports Centre, it all paid off for him, because he was taken six rounds further than ever tonight and got home. And let's just hear the decision now. Well, it's not, we're not quite ready for it. We're not quite, are we ready? We're a bit of confusion. Scorecards have to be checked. Ed Levine is the WBU's supervisor. They're a world governing body trying to get a foothold in Britain. We don't really need new world governing bodies, but don't tell anybody that here tonight. We've got to get out of the place.
Well, I'd be amazed if this was a close fight. I'm certain that Neary is a big, big winner on points here.
Still, we wait. Seems to be taking them an eternity to add up the scores and confirm them. Right, I think we're ready for our MC, John McDonald.
Ladies and gentlemen, sports fans, our Sky viewers joining us here on ringside. The judges' results are as follows. Judge Dave Parrish scores the contest 119-110. Judge Don O'Neill scores the contest 118-110. And Judge Torben Hansen scores the contest 119-110. All in favour of the new World Boxing Union's light waterweight champion of the world, the Shamrock Express, Shane Neary.
Joyous scenes, deliriously happy Merseyside fans. I've seen a night to remember here. Shea Neary is the WBU's light welterweight champion.
And stay with us. A short break, and when we come back, we'll get a word with the new champion in the middle of that throng.
We've had a splendid night's boxing here in Liverpool. And the top story, Shea Neary has broken through. Here he is with Ian Dark.
Tell us about the fight. First of all, how much it means to you to make this big graduation to world level and world class.
It doesn't mean nothing to me, nothing at all, nothing whatsoever. But to my father upstairs, Shea Neary Sr., he's done it for me. He's the only one.
And now, you had to go there the full 12 rounds. You've never been beyond six before. Did you feel the stamina might become a problem for you?
Well, you know, I was winning the first four easy, I knew that. Well, broke my hand in the fourth round. Well, I don't know how this broke, but I couldn't use it from the fourth. It was, I caught him in the second, piece of a punch, Brendan.
Your right hand was broken from the fourth round?
Fourth round. I'll show you the evidence, if you want to see it. Can you just get a shot of Brendan Devine, my other manager?
Well, we can't do that, but what you've mentioned him, yeah.
Please get a shot in, please. Come on, Brendan, get in.
Well, here is Brendan Devine. He's the manager. Kiss for him. We're running short on time. Just tell us how you're going to celebrate this tonight.
Well, me and Mick Conley are going to the Salisbury pub. Anyway, all the invites are welcome. It's going to be a great night.
Okay, well done tonight. Enjoy it.
I'll see you in Vegas again, eh?
Hope so.
Let's hope it's the mother of all parties. He deserves it, doesn't he? Your thoughts on that performance, Barry?
God, that was a fabulous performance. What a fight. 12 rounds of non-stop action. And I thought Neary came through a couple of dicey moments. He was hurt a few times, got a great chin. And I thought his performance on the whole was fantastic. He raised his performance remarkably.
Robin Reid.
Yeah, great performance. Boxed there like a true professional. You know, we had some. He started off in the first four rounds, he won, you know, clearly. Then, like Barry said, then a few rounds he tend to, you know, not, I wouldn't say he lost him, but, you know, he looked like he was letting him come back into the fight. But great performance and, you know, good tactical battle as well. You know, he didn't go in there trying to land big punches and knock the bloke out. He picked his punches well, hurt him, and good win.
Thanks, Robin. Time for us to go. Hope very much you've enjoyed it. We'll see you again next weekend. Big night for Clifton Mitchell. He's fighting in Germany for the European heavyweight title against Zeljko Mavrovic next Saturday, Sky Sports 1 at 8. And just a reminder about Golden Gloves on Sunday night. Muhammad Ali in his prime, remembered by Barry McGuigan. Action from the 60s, including this performance against Cleveland Williams. And also next Wednesday at 7 on Sky Sports 1, Ali in his latter life. The magic still intact, proving it to Fidel Castro, among others. Ali as he is today. Sky Sports 1, Wednesday at 7. Hope very much you've enjoyed it. You can make up your own mind about the WBU. What's beyond doubt is that we've had an outstanding international contest here. Bye for now.